Welcome to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Super Talk Mississippi 93.7 Spotlight is on Northwest Community College, and you can listen to our live stream at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Here's your host, Gary Darby.
Welcome to the first Thursday of August and our first Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. As well, from now until 10, this is what we shall do. First, Angela Dortch returns to the program, District Director of Admissions and Records. Angela will be talking 2022 graduation. They just had a summer commencement. We'll get into that with some numbers and degrees and things and getting ready for the upcoming school semester with Angela first, and then we will talk with LaQuita Smith-Parker, who's Director of Student Support Services, about things called Welcome Week and the Ranger Roundup. It's time to get things going on the campuses of Northwest Community College with students coming in, getting everyone, staff, professors, and everyone lined up and ready to go and educate the people for another semester. So we will have Angela Dortch and LaQuita Smith-Parker on our program today, talking about admissions, graduations, Welcome Week, Ranger Roundup. We've got other information we'll get to you at the back end of the program, which will surround sports, some things that we need to announce. Meet the Rangers has been publicized now. We'll get to that. We have a new rodeo coach at Northwest as well. We have some other things we'll get to the back end of the program. It's 9:08. Again today, coming up in the second portion of the show, the Director of Student Support Services, LaQuita Smith-Parker. She's going to be talking to us about Welcome Week and the Ranger Roundup. But next, we'll take a trip to the main campus, and we will discuss with the District Director of Admissions and Records, Angela Dortch, a little bit about summer commencement and how we're getting everybody admitted and ready to go for the upcoming semester. It's 9:11. The Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour is underway.
You're listening to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College on Super Talk Mississippi 93.7 and stream live at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour.
Our friend Angela Dortch is on the phone line with us, District Director of Admissions and Records. We were going over a couple of things in the discussion before we get on here, and both of us dealing with some yard work and things going on. I'm sore, Angela. How about you? Are you okay?
No, I'm sore, too. I'm in a knee brace. So,
oh,
but no. The grass still grows, so I have to get it done.
I know. I didn't get finished. I'm about to get back out there and get some more of it done. If the little maybe possible little rain showers we could get later on in the day hold off. But I feel you, and I really appreciate you being back and doing our program again. I think it was May the 5th, you know, when we were graduating and doing some things in and around that time that we had you on and talking about different things. And now, Angela, we've had another one. We had a summer commencement. We're going to talk about that. I want to get you into the, you know, admissions that's going on and everything as we're getting ready to do this again. How many graduates did we have just recently with the summer commencement?
We had 201 walk across the stage this summer commencement. It was an exciting, beautiful event. Very successful.
Is it continuing to grow? Because now we've talked about this, but actually being able to get, you know, moms, dads, brothers, sisters, grandmas, grandpas, things like that, that it's now is building back into, you know, a big fun event for everybody?
Yes, it is. You know, since COVID has come and, you know, we're working through all of that, students have continued to hang in there, and more students want to come back to school to get that degree so that they can have a brighter future. So, yes, it's growing, and that's the exciting part of it. To see those students with the smiles on their face knowing that they did it, you know, and that's something that nobody can take away from them.
So we handed diplomas to 201, you said. Can you kind of maybe take us through some of the majors, some of the degrees? What was happening there?
Well, you know, this summer we had students who received the Associate of Arts, Associate of Applied Science Career and Technical Certificates. We've had 201 students that walk across the stage, but we probably had about 300 students to apply for summer graduation, and some of them did not want to participate.
I got you.
So, but it's growing. It's growing. Every time we have a commencement, it grows. So I'm excited about it.
Can that be twofold because of all of the new technical programs and the things that Northwest is getting involved in? How large and how big are those getting with Northwest?
Well, you know, Gary, it's kind of hard to say, but I can say we've seen an increase in it. I mean, with the new programs that we have coming to Northwest, it's just attracting more students. You know, the cybersecurity at the DeSoto Center, mm-hmm. I mean, it's just the HCA program with School of Health Science has tremendously grown. The LPN program, the RN program, all of our career techs, we've seen an increase in that. And academically-wise, you know, we've seen the increase in that. You know, everybody has their different paths that they want to take, but with all the different opportunities that we offer here at Northwest, I just think that we have a good brand. I think we're moving more to the future, and we're all about being student-ready, so Northwest is growing, and we have a leadership. Our president, Heindel, he's really out there trying to get all of the things in place. And with the amount of administration and leadership and all the great ideas that's coming together, Northwest is just going to be awesome. It's already awesome, but I just look forward to the future with everything that we have coming on.
Angela Dortch is with us. And Angela, I know Northwest is always focused on adult education and done things as well. Any idea, and again, I hope I'm not putting you on the spot, but can you discuss a little bit of that and how Northwest is expanding in that role?
That role is expanding. I know that we were the largest of the schools to have adult ed graduates.
Good.
Which is exciting. And each and every time that these students receive that degree, and when they come over and they fill out an admissions application, my team and I, every time we get it, we always give them a big congratulations because that's an exciting time, you know, just to see the adult students come back to receive that credential and want to move on. I mean, it's just awesome. And then once we see the smile on their faces, you know, the conversations leads and the more questions begin to ask. And we always hear them say, you know, I did it, so I want to tell somebody else that I did it so that they can come and do the same.
Absolutely. Angela, you guys, I guess, have had a small amount of time then since, you know, the graduation happened, and now you're getting ready for the admissions process. Get everybody in and going and make sure all the I's are dotted and the T's are crossed. How crazy is your office right now?
My office is extremely crazy, but that's a good crazy.
Sure, that's right.
That's a good thing to be. Trying to get all the degrees awarded and at the same time having open registration on the 10th, 11th, and 12th and getting ready for the students and just want them to know that, you know, it's not too late. Apply. You know, we got the fall semester coming in and coming up. It's still not too late to apply. If that's something that a student would like to do and would like to be a part of us, we would love to have them. So come on in and apply. Visit admissions, and we'll get you walked through the steps of what you need to do.
Can you tell the listeners that may not know where admissions is on the campus, what building, and how to find you?
Okay, on the Senatobia campus, you can find the admissions office on the second floor in the Yalabusha building. We also have an admissions staff at the DeSoto Center and at the Oxford Center that can help you with anything.
And I think we've made this comment before, but there could be a question, you know, in the DeSoto campus that may need to be referred to you, but you guys can help each other with whatever campus it is, correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. If there's any questions that someone at DeSoto may not have, we're just a phone call away. So I just want the students to know that they would get the help, and any questions that they may have, they would get it answered. All I ask them to do is just come in and ask the questions, and please don't be shy.
Are there any special form, like let's just say we've got some people that are getting ready to register and know it's, you just mentioned, not too late, but we need to hurry up. Are there any special forms, any special things, or what do we need to know to get our student, whether it's, you know, a first year or maybe an adult coming back?
Well, all we just need to do is they apply. And if you have any students that are just graduating from high school or just receiving their high school equivalency, we need an official copy of that transcript. If they've attended any other college or institutions, we need all official copies of those transcripts as well. And most universities, most schools are now doing it electronically. So once they order and once they have them sent to us, we can receive those ASAP.
Can you apply online?
You can. Okay. If you go to the northwestms.edu website and go to the admissions tab, you'll see apply online, and you just go in and apply and submit your application.
Well, I hope that someday your office will settle down just a little bit, but that's a couple of weeks, huh?
I mean, you know what?
At a minimum.
I'll take it. We may settle down just a little bit, but then we're right back at it because we also have the mini terms coming up, second mini term in October. So we're always registering. We always have classes starting. So I just encourage students to let them know that it's not too late.
Well, I appreciate a small amount of time for you again. We'll tell them all the ways to do it, and I look forward to our next conversation when we find out how many more young men and women are old men and women like me, you may be pushing out into the world and continuing that education. Another good conversation with you, Angela. Try and have a good day, okay?
Thank you so much, Gary.
Take care of that knee. Take care of the knee.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks, Angela.
Okay.
Angela Dortch with us, talking about 201 in the summer commencement and putting them out in different associate degrees and talking in the technical world as well and what they can do. Listen, if, as she said, not too late to get ready and apply. Maybe you thought you were going to do one thing, and now, okay, I'm going to stay home. I'm going to stay close to home where I can go far. I can do what I need to do at Northwest Community College. Go to the website northwestms.edu, northwestms.edu. You can apply online. Pretty simple. I'm looking at the process now. You create your account. You get a username, the password, make sure you know all of that, and then you continue and just go through with all the pertinent information, get that going, and boom, they'll be there to help you. And to that point, there is a place where you can chat and someone's there and you can ask your questions there. There's all ways to find out about things, how to apply online, the admission forms, different things, financial aid, all of that you'll need to know. And hopefully you'll get those answers in a hurry. As she said, I think she was talking about a week or so for that process and then get you into the classroom and going at a place that's there for you, whether it's the main campus in Senatobia, the DeSoto campus, or the Lafayette Yallabusha campus in Oxford, or then they have the concourse in Batesville. They have all different kind of things for you. The way to check it all out, northwestms.edu. Main phone number on the main campus is 562-3200. You have any questions, it is easy to figure it out at Northwest Community College. 925, Gary and Arby in the LitcoMetals.com studio. Right around 80 now with sunshine, but expect the possibility of some scattered storms around 2 or 3 o'clock this afternoon. Next up, what are we going to do? We're going to talk with LaQuita Smith-Parker. She's the Student Support Services Director at NWCC. What is Welcome Week? What is the Ranger Roundup? We're going to get all that information and more next.
This hour is everything Northwest. Your connection to Northwest Community College and powered by Sycamore Bank. Thanks for joining us on the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
Our thanks to Angela Dortch, the District Director of Admissions and Records, for talking to us about commencement, admission. We get them on the campus, get them graduated, move them on into what form of life is next. And then, once we get them on that campus, we're going to put them kind of in the hands of the Director of Student Support Services, LaQuita Smith-Parker, who's on the phone. How you doing, lady?
How are you? Good morning.
Things are good. It was May since I last talked with Angela. I think it was April since you and I last talk. Always good to get two fine guests on and talk with us about the things that are going on. I hope everything is good in your world and you're ready and have already hit the ground running and continuing to move towards what will be the first day we get these students back on campus.
Everything is going well, and we are gearing up to welcome our students back to our campus for the fall semester.
All right, let's talk about Welcome Week. What week is that? When will we get this started?
So Welcome Week is an exciting week of events and activities for students coming back to our campus, and we kick off on Sunday, August 14th.
Sunday, August 14th. So we get them on campus, and what are we going to start doing with them once we get there?
On Sunday, August 14th, on our Senatobia campus, we'll start with a prayer walk sponsored by our FCA starting at 6 p.m.
Get that going and moving forward. And I guess we have a full week. I mean, your calendar has to be booked, right? I mean, just kind of take us through some of the things that the students will do.
Of course, we do have a full week of events for students. Starting on Monday, we kick off with our Ranger Roundup at 6 p.m. in the Coliseum. And this is a big event featuring our amazing drumline and our championship cheer team to help students learn about all the student organizations and services available on our campus. Students will also have the opportunity to win prizes and enjoy free popcorn and snow cones sponsored by our local Lions Club. And then on Tuesday, of course, it's Taco Tuesday, so we'll have tacos in the cafeteria for lunch for students and a glow party that evening at the Rock at 6:30. Wednesday for students, we have a work-study job fair for students still looking for placement at the cafeteria during lunchtime, and we'll wrap up Wednesday with a movie night at 6:30 in the Fine Arts Auditorium. Then on Thursday, we have an ice cream social for students during lunch, and that is sponsored by our Baptist Student Union. Then throughout the week each day, around campus starting at 7:30 a.m., there will be resource tents for students who have questions, who need directions, or who just may need to grab a bottle of water on these hot days.
Yes, no doubt.
And so all of these events are on our Senatobia campus, and they're open to all of our Northwest students. But we also have a couple of events on our DeSoto campus. We have the Welcome Back Expo, and on our Oxford campus, we have coffee and donuts. So we just have a full week of exciting things for our students to come back and get acclimated to our campus.
Is there a way for people to find out all of these events?
Absolutely. Our Welcome Back Week is posted on our social media accounts, on our Northwest Student Life Facebook page. You should also see it on Instagram. And students should also see the information once they get to campus. It will be in their folders or posted in their dorms and around office building.
You know, this entire week, when you're getting, you know, a first-time college student, you know, I don't know, some come from large high schools, some come, like I did, from a really small high school, and so classes, you know, even though they may be smaller at Northwest than jumping somewhere else for that first year of education, still for me, the classes were larger than I was accustomed to. There's sometimes when you get on a campus, and, LaQuita, we can be a little overwhelmed with everything. This week is basically to try and help a person just acquaint themselves to what is available on that campus, correct?
Absolutely, absolutely. Whether it's a big campus or a small campus, it's still new for students.
Yeah.
So we want to make sure that they feel comfortable, that they have staff available to answer any of their questions, and that they feel welcome to our campus.
Because they need to know, all right, I've got to go to this building at 8 a.m., and then I got to figure out how to get over here, you know, at some point in time. And that's why I think when I heard you say there will be, you know, places set up on campus for questions or things of that nature, that really, you know, a welcome thing that I think is going to be good for a lot of the youngsters. And then they may not know. I think when you were talking about having, you know, the Ranger Roundup and the things that will be, you know, I guess Howard Coliseum, correct?
Correct.
And they may not know all of the organizations and things that are on campus. May be surprised to find some of these things.
Absolutely.
That they can get that information. I think is a great learning experience all the way around.
Absolutely. We have a lot of great student organizations and free services for students, and the Ranger Roundup is a way to make sure that students are aware of what we have to offer.
And then, you know, I guess, too, I mean, when you mention, you know, places like Baptist Student Union, you talked about the FCA, you talked about other different things, they can figure out, okay, Monday nights, this organization meets. Tuesday nights, this can happen. You know, we've got football games that are getting started on Thursdays, and we've got soccer or whatever that may be going on at some point in time. That's a lot of information to try and get to these people in a week. Are we ready to do that?
We are up and ready to go.
I would imagine that you guys have been gearing up and ready to work and to get this going for quite some time now. All right, so we can go to the social media sites and find these things out again. You piqued my interest with popcorn and snow cones. So
popcorn and snow cones.
Everybody likes popcorn and snow cones, don't they? And get that going as well. So we'll find out all of that information. Anything else from the student support services world that you need to mention or want to mention before we let you go?
Just real quick, in addition to the sponsors that I've already mentioned, I would like to acknowledge Selfie Memphis, our student organization advisors, and all the staff volunteers who are assisting with our Welcome Week. And I would like to send a special thanks to our leadership, Dr. Heindel and Dr. Rush, for their vision and their commitment to enriching our student lives with exciting events like the Welcome Week we have for our students.
Excellent. Look, I appreciate some time again. We'll be back with you, I know, to talk about other things with our students as the semester goes along. Get rest as much as you can, and let's get ready for the week that's coming up, okay?
Thank you. I appreciate the opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am. That's our friend, LaQuita Smith-Parker, who joins us as the Director of Student Support Services, talking with us about Welcome Week and also the Ranger Roundup, which is part of that week. And as she said, you can go to their social media sites and you can find that out with Student Support Services on the Northwest Campus. Kind of get a list of what they do. They kind of welcome you in on Sunday, take you through things each and every day of the week, lead you in, students, so that you're familiar with your new surroundings and everything that you need to know along the way. So thank her for being on our program as well. It is 9:37. Take a time out, come back, and I've got some things we need to discuss still in the Northwest Community College world. Working on a Thursday, August 4th, it's the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour.
We're talking Rangers this hour. Thanks for joining us for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. It's a special conversation about Northwest Community College. There's a campus near you and more to come. And you can join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
I encourage you to do that. Stick around the program however you can, but you can always text message into the LitcoMetals.com studio at 662-426-1093. If you hear this voice, if I'm talking with you, it'll come straight to me. I am on the Facebook page for the Northwest Student Life that LaQuita was talking to us about moments ago. And here's some of the things that are up there. And if you have a student that will be going to Northwest in this next semester or going through that process and getting ready to apply and do those things, if they're going to live in a dorm, coming up Wednesday, Thursday, Friday of next week is move-in day, 9 a.m. to 4:30, and then on Sunday from 1 until 5. So those are the move-in days for 2022 for Northwest Community College. If you're going to a dorm, new and returning students, that's when it's going to be here. Again, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday from 9 a.m. to 4:30, and Sunday from 1 to 5. You have to be fully registered via the MyNWCC before you can check in. But if you have done so, you can go ahead and pick your time. There's a place called picktime.com/Northwest check-ins. But if you need, again, the Facebook site is Northwest Student Life. You can go and you can check that out. Plus, there's the whole list of everything that happens with Welcome Week, starting Sunday with the prayer walk, Monday, you have the resource tents that are going to be up starting at 7:30. The Ranger Roundup will be at Howard Coliseum that evening. Tuesday, Taco Tuesday for lunch in the cafeteria. You get Rock the Rock. It's a glow party that's going to go on at the Ranger Outdoor Complex. That'll go on from 6:30 until 9:30. And we'll continue to go with Wednesday Work study job fair. Need some work? They'll put you to it, and you can get that education at the same time. But you'll have to check that out. And then movie night at the Fine Arts Auditorium at 6:30. Thursday's the ice cream social at the cafeteria from 1 until 3. All of that going on. So you can go to the Facebook page, Northwest Student Life. I think they have an Instagram at NWCC Student Life as well. Welcome week. Get started on Sunday. Goes through Thursday, the 14th through the 18th, as they get everybody back and rolling there on the main campus in Senatobia. And as she mentioned, there are things that will be happening on the DeSoto campus and the Oxford campus as well. And all you have to do is go and find all of those things out and take a peek. We also had the discussion with Angela about the summer commencement. There's some photos on this Northwest Student Life Facebook page that I'm looking at, congratulating the summer grads of 2022. You can see some smiling people in the cap and gowns, and knowing that they have got the associate's degree and moving on into that next chapter of life. So if you have any questions or anything, pretty good way to go do it too, on the Facebook page, Northwest Student Life. It tells you all about Welcome Week, even there on the DeSoto campus, as well as the Oxford campus, as they'll have the Welcome Back Expo on the DeSoto campus on Monday the 15th. And then Tuesday, they'll have different things going on as well from 10 until 2 each week. And on the Oxford campus, they'll be doing things on that Monday and Tuesday as well. And then evening school things going on the Northwest Oxford campus, whether it's coffee and donuts on Monday and Tuesday or popcorn and evening school, free while the supplies last, of course, as we get students coming in for regular classes, evening classes, and everything going on the Oxford campus. So please check it out. And there are all different bits of information that you can get and to see. Northwest Student Life Facebook page. You can go far close to home there with NWCC. So check all of that out, if you will. You can also check this out. Northwest will have the start to their sports season with Meet the Rangers coming up on Wednesday, August the 24th. That'll be at 7 o'clock. Admission free. Now you'll get the chance as you go to Bobby Franklin Field to see as they recognize members of the rodeo, the volleyball, the football, the men and women's soccer teams, cheerleaders, the dance team, and the Ranger Marching Band. So you'll have all of that starting at 7 o'clock on Wednesday, August the 24th. And sports season is closing in. You'll have soccer getting ready very soon. We will have an opportunity, I'm sure, to talk to the new men's soccer coach very soon. We've talked to James Beatty on the women's soccer side and their season coming up. We talked to volleyball coach Allison Burchett here recently and her season and volleyball getting ready to kickstart. We've got all that going on. And then your nationally ranked football team will get going as well there on as the months close in. So we'll have Wednesday, August the 24th at 7, the opportunity to meet the Rangers. That's when that's scheduled for the fall sports season. And we have a new rodeo coach. And we've been announcing new coaches here recently. As we mentioned, new men's soccer coach. We've got new women's basketball coach, assistants on both men and women's basketball teams that have happened recently. But now, international steer wrestler, I mean, he's been in events and have been doing things recently, winning big time. Will Loomis has been selected to lead the Rangers rodeo program. They announced that on Monday morning. Comes to Northwest with a strong professional resume, as I said. I'm looking at the release from our buddy Brian Lentz. It's highlighted by an average title in the 2021 Wrangler National Finals Rodeo and a number two world ranking in steer wrestling. Loomis has competed around the world. He joined the rodeo circuits in 2012, and he's now the new rodeo coach. The season for rodeo is set for the 2022-2023 Ozark campaign, the Ozark region that they compete in late September in the Viking Stampede, which is hosted by Missouri Valley College. They travel all over the place. So can't wait to talk to the new rodeo coach, too, at some point. And we'll find out his thoughts on that and a man that's been competing up until this day. And I will find that question. Will he still be, you know, steer wrestling while he's coaching? But obviously someone that can help both the men and the women that are on that rodeo team there at Northwest. The Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, later on, it'll be up on the podcast form as well for you to go back and listen to our interviews with Angela and LaQuita. And I thank both ladies for being on with us, talking about everything we did to get ready for the upcoming semester and welcoming everybody back. Staff and our professors and people that do all of the work in and around that Northwest campus, making it what it is, whichever campus it is, the best it can possibly be. Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour on this Thursday, August the 4th. We thank Angela Dortch. We thank LaQuita Smith-Parker for being on with us today and helping us talk about a little commencement from the summer, how to apply and admissions and things that you still need to do and can do, not too late, to get that education started at Northwest. And then LaQuita with Student Services speaking to us about the fun events and everything they have ready to go once you get on that campus coming up next week. And again, you can go to their Facebook page, Northwest Student Life, find all of it out there and more. And then any questions that you have, you can always refer to the school website, northwestms.edu. Or if you're looking for the sporting events and the different things that I mentioned as well, want to read about some of those new coaches or meet the Rangers, nwccrangers.com. Everybody in the PR staff and the sports side of things do a tremendous job of keeping us up to date of what's going on at Northwest Community College. But for right now at 9:54 on your Thursday, I got to move. Gerard's next. He'll take you for the next 3 hours. As I exit the LitcoMetals.com studio, I say so long.